At Europe's spaceport in French Guiana, the newly built launch complex for Ariane 6 is ready. Currently, the European Space Agency, ESA, the French space agency, CNES, and Ariane Group are conducting combined tests between rocket and launch base. With these final tests and the recent inauguration of the launch pad, ESA's new Ariane 6 launch vehicle is now entering its final phase of development before its inaugural flight. Despite COVID restrictions across the globe, the development of Ariane 6 has continued. And over the last few months, we have seen much activity in French Guiana and ESA member states.
In March 2020, the Ariane 6 launch complex was closed due to COVID-19. A lot of efforts were put to resume the activity in safe situation for the workers. With the better knowledge of the pandemic and the implementation of the safety barrier, the activity resumed. Since that period, a lot of work was performed and many steps are behind us. All the buildings are now complete and we are installing the system inside. We are in the test phase of this system.
But the work has not only continued in French Guiana. Across ESA member states, the assembly and testing of Ariane 6 stages is ongoing. Soon, the Ariane 6 upper stage will be tested in the newly built DLR test bench in Lampoldshausen, Germany. The tests will simulate all aspects of flight, including stage preparation such as fueling with liquid oxygen and liquid hydrogen, and draining the stage's tanks. Earlier this year, tests were also performed in Fos-sur-Mer in France. Here, the so-called umbilicals, which are used to fuel the launch vehicle, were tested, and their release from the rocket at liftoff was simulated. A critical phase before and during launch, as through this system, the fuel tanks on both the upper and lower stage of Ariane 6's central core will be filled with liquid hydrogen and liquid oxygen. An explosive combination, and the release of the fueling system needs to be spot on.
For the upper stage, the system is composed of two arms connected to the mast of the launch table. One arm is for the liquid oxygen, the other arm is for liquid hydrogen. They are connected to the upper stage to fill the tanks and disconnected at liftoff. Comparing to Ariane 5, we have also two arms, but these arms are disconnected before the takeoff, before the liftoff. In this case, for Ariane 6, they will remain connected to the launcher till the liftoff. We will open these arms very quickly in order not to interfere with the launcher during liftoff. And you can see also two doors that will be closed during the movement of the arms in order to protect the connection, the interface with the launchers.
Leading up to Ariane 6's inaugural flight, combined tests will be performed at Europe's spaceport in French Guiana. During these tests, the launch base with the launch pad will interface with the real elements of the rocket. This allows ESA to test all systems, validate operations and procedures, and run various simulations connected to real-life launch operations. With these tests, ESA takes another step forward in the development of its sixth-generation Ariane rocket, continuing over four decades of Ariane excellence and offering Europe and the world a new and unique launch vehicle.
What makes Ariane 6 unique? It's clear it's a strategic workhorse for Europe for its freedom of action of tomorrow. Today we have Ariane 5, tomorrow we'll have Ariane 6. Ariane 6 will be much more modular, we'll have an enhanced portfolio of missions, and all this for a lower cost for the public sector. That's really fundamental. In addition to that, we will also have the opportunity to launch crucial missions with a European family of launchers. We will have only European developed launchers launching Galileo, launching Copernicus with the Vega C, but also for science missions, for exploration missions, a real new opportunity.
Like other ESA programs, Ariane 6 is the result of partnership and teamwork, bringing industry, national space agencies, and ESA member states together, striving towards independent access to space for Europe. Ariane 6 will be a worthy successor of Ariane 5 and previous generations, and is also the beacon for a bright future for Europe in space.